Now, youth unemployment, it is a ticking time bomb, as has been described, when 65% of the population is made up of the youth, mm-hmm. and a huge chunk of that is unemployed. Mm-hmm. All right, joining
about,
us...
Over 20 million.
Yes, indeed. Social commentator Razak Olukoba is joining us this morning to look at this. Good morning, good to have you.
Good morning.
Nice to see you.
Yeah, exactly. Show.
Good morning, viewers.
You're welcome.
Okay, so what do you think about this? We spoke with some people on the streets there, and one of the respondents pointed out the fact that Nigerian youth is ready to do anything. The get-rich-quick syndrome, is that how you might want to describe it?
Yeah, of course. Every youth, you have exuberance that is synonymous with them. And it's the duty of every nation to direct the exuberance for productive purpose. Mm-hmm. If you don't do that, you have a direct consequence, which is partly what we are witnessing in Nigeria today. Maybe in the south-south, in the southeast, and probably in the north. The reason why we have army of insurgents is grossly because of an unemployment rate. So it is a thing that a nation must pay attention to. Mm-hmm. And it's not be done in isolation. Government should be responsible. Society should be responsible, parents should be responsible, and the youth must also be willing. Yeah. Yeah. A peculiar problem in Nigeria, which is not synonymous with the rest of the world, is a seemingly unwillingness from Nigerian youth to engage in what to give them that line of what is called a daily bread. There's that thing that is becoming border worrisome, that just like what
do you think that is?
Well, just like what the guy said here, that 80% of Nigerian youth, that's alarming, want to do a job that will give them money
quick.
And that's why.
But where is that coming from, actually?
That's why.
It never used to be like that.
Yes, that's why I said a nation must be responsible for directing that exuberance. Mm. In the past, you have sports, you have all sorts of activities that's. Exuberance
is channeled
into it. That has been abandoned. So you allow the youth to take initiatives. So all those first sectors I've mentioned, the government, society itself, the parent, and the youth, I found one thing. We didn't get it right. But even if the government fails, because I want to redirect the blame game now. Mm-hmm. Government fails, society fails, parents fail. Youth themselves must be conscious. Way back, people led protests to say that we don't want sharp. People led protests to say that youth, young people, almost as a teenager, that we don't want this government again. But today, it's going to take you, it's an Herculean task to convince you to that. I'm talking about your future. Mm. You sleep too much. You talk too much. You wish too much. I wish I was Ronaldo. I would do. That's not to succeed.
Yeah, but has today's youth been equipped to the point where he can actually, process what, his life should be compared to what is? Right now, because look at education. Governments down the line have talked about human capital development and all of that without paying attention to education. Education continues to take a very, very almost
I don't want to be indulging.
This kind of
argument is indulging. Yes. The argument that government is responsible, the parents are responsible, the society is responsible, is indulging. And that's what it doesn't inspire them again. But by the time you start telling them the stories of Alexander the Great, who conquered the entire world at the age of 19, tell them about Muhammad, 40. He has 2 billion followers. Christ, at the age of what? So, Obasanjo became a retired head of state and a general at the age of 40. The one at 29. Mm-hmm. So, we can begin to mention and on.
So there's no excuse. It is getting the right way to inspire them.
Yeah, the right way to inspire them is not to start talking about government again, because what is government is beginning to look in the right direction. And now, look at Lagos. Look at what the incident of the other day. There's no reason why Lagos should be doing what it's doing, and you still find some youth engaging in that kind of a violence. It's not, I won't hold government responsible for that. I was younger. I was 25 years ago, I knew what I was doing with my life. I've been sent out of school because I led a protest against the government for trying to take a sharp serious for taking a World Bank loan. So, but today, if you sue them, they say our government is not doing anything. But if there are platforms, there's a particular show that we have 30 million youth. applying for it with 15 naira. You know what you know what that costs. And at the end of the day, you see other platforms where that debate is going on. You'll be begging them to come and participate in.
Yeah, but when you blame the youth, you're putting the blame on the youth. What about the pictures that we put in front of the youth, where the youth have been made to believe that hard work really does not pay?
Yeah, I agree with you.
Which, you know.
I agree with you because.
Because when they observe the politicians, the political class, when they observe, you know, the older people.
I get it. We should hold society responsible for that, particularly the government. If you see someone who is a politician do all sorts of things to get rich and there are no consequences, it is a way of inspiring the youth that hard work doesn't pay in Nigeria. What I'm saying is that let's see some kind of readiness, willingness on the side of the youth. Having said that, and that should be our intro at all time, that you must be ready. You must be ready to take it away from the adults who are misleading you. You must be. Having said that, you now say, we know that you are in this mess. Not entirely your fault.
How can you make the best of a bad situation?
Now, how to make the best of the bad situation is, let the society realize the danger in not equipping the youth, in not educating the youth. We must first admit the danger in it.
Isn't the society even benefiting from the youth being like that? Because we just talked about the issue.
We thought we are benefiting, we are not benefiting.
Yeah, exactly. Mm. But that's what I'm saying. But because the issue there is the immediate benefit. We just talked about the issue of thuggery involved in thuggery in elections.
Yes. Yeah.
The point there is we know the long-term consequences, but somebody will win election and feel, okay, fine, I use thugs and I have my election. Mm. So
then where do you go from there? We are not going anywhere from there. Uh-huh. You win an election. If you win an election as a member of the parliament, it doesn't take your country anywhere. Mm. And in any case, if you think you take your children abroad, train them and bring them back home, who will run the economy, the industry you are creating? You give your child sophisticated education to come and preside over someone, you give a rickety education. You can't succeed.
It's a mismatch.
Okay. So that's what I'm saying. Like, we are not going anywhere. We must first admit that there's a danger in the future for us. A direct consequence of those negligence is what we are witnessing today.
Who will inspire
and now,
that? That's...
And now, from what the government of the country is doing at the moment, I think they are beginning to look in the right direction.
Sufficient attention
has been paid to education.
Really?
With less than
5% of the national budget?
ASU is still on strike.
No, it's been sorted out. Unlike before, it's been sorted out. Now, there are other ventures that inspire you to pay more attention to the country. The image of your country is also very, very important. Mm. It's part of the reason why you to say nothing is working in Nigeria.
Yeah.
As and I talk,
okay.
You are aware that there are four European countries in one of 10 leading economies in the world. There's no single African country there. So those are kind of the issue. But within Nigeria is doing, either by question or either by merit, Nigeria is going to make that list very soon as one of the first leading 10 economic in the world. So
let's keep hope alive.
By and large, we should keep working. We should keep educating the youth, giving them the orientation that you have a future. This is the path. This path leads to perdition. This path leads to greatness.
Okay. All right.
We have to leave it here now. Razak Olukoba, thank you so much for coming on the program.
It's a pleasure being with you.
Thank you.
Right.